Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, Namaskaram. Welcome to the 6th episode of Sangam Literature and Tamil Society series. The last episode, we were discussing about the 5 landscapes and how that has been exploited best to bring out the emotions associated with love. Starting from meeting, falling in love at first sight, all the way up to separation, temporal and permanent. So these emotions have been played with using the landscape as a canvas. Today's song is going to be another very, very popular song that has been used extensively in films. And so you get to see it, you would have definitely heard it if you're fairly familiar with Tamil film music. So this particular song is very special for a lot of reasons, because this is set in a moment when the hero and heroine were conversing after falling in love. Now that they were convinced about taking up a married and a committed life, they were discussing about what brought them both together. Now that, you know, they're going to get married, how are things going to change? Marriage in Tamil society is best understood through this very simple and a popular song. So they take it to a level where they start thinking about, we didn't know each other till the moment we fell in love. Somehow we got to know better mutually. And now that we're going to get married, your dad and my dad, who were in no way related, are now going to be relatives. So is it with your mother? And what has brought us together and what has bound us like this? So this is like two families that are not connected in any way meeting, and one marriage kind of bringing all of them together. And so a wedding is not just a relationship between a man and a woman, but it is more about two families getting along and becoming relatives. And so this kind of gives a sense of warmth and the discussion, and they feel there's a sense of oneness that is brought in, and it kind of emotionally charges both of them about the kind of responsibilities probably they have, because things aren't about just two of them anymore. It's got an extension. There are more people involved. And when there are two different families involved, that's like a part of the society getting along. So maybe two different sections of the same society getting along, mixing. And so that's a new birth. It's a birth of something new that's going to talk up from there. The song is very popular. I'm just reading it out. Yayum yayum yara hiero, yendayum nundayum yemurai kele, yanum niyum yevvali aridum, chembulappayal neer pole, anbudai nenjam tam kalandanave. This is from Kurunthogai, the 40th song. And we're not sure about the actual name of the poet, but he's called as Sembula Payanirar. The names of Sangam poets is a separate topic. Maybe in one of the episodes, I'll try and cover that. But here, this poet's, the kind of simile that he has used in this, the penultimate line of this poem, has earned him her name, a very exclusive name. He says, the hero probably says that, you know, the way we have gelled together, the way we have gotten one into another, is like how water mixes with red soil. So once water falls on red soil, let's say rainwater falls on red soil, it kind of puddles there, mixes so well that there is no scope to separate them both after that. Once they've gotten into one another like that, once they've mixed so well, the red soil, the dry red soil and the water cannot be separated. So this is how we are together. Now this beautiful simile that the poet had used has earned him the same phrase as his name. So he's called as Sembula Payanirar. Payanirar. So that's about the rainwater that falls in red earth. My mother and your mother, what are they to each other? My father and your father, how are they related? You and I, how did we know each other? So this is what the hero asks. I mean, a kind of doubt that comes after some time. I mean, she was not known to him. And so the other way too. So they were mutually, they had no clue about one another, and they were not used to each other. But now suddenly there is a sense of care, a sense of love, and there's a sense of friendship, and all of that has come in and extremely strong. There are several other people with whom she is used to ever since her birth, and the way he also, but suddenly everybody is pushed aside And this one person who was unknown till a few days back becomes like the most important in life. Now, that's a very, very unique relationship. And that's probably one main reason that makes a husband and wife relationship to be very unique. So he says, my mother and your mother, what were they to each other? How were they related? So did she really care? Did my mother care for your mother or the other way? Or we just never there. Okay, what about our fathers? They were also, they didn't know each other. And, they had no idea about the other person. So that's how they were. Why go to your father and mother? Now, let's consider ourselves. You and I, how did we even know each other? We're not sure. But something there was much beyond our senses that kind of bound us together. Now, this is exactly where the concept of power of love and falling in love at first sight is brought in. And in most cases, being the kind of rich literature it is, the concept of having known each other for several births is reestablished. So the very tenet that the traditional Tamil literature is brought about, this philosophy that believes in the cycle of birth and death is time and again reiterated. So the hero says that I didn't know you. Neither did my mother know your mother, nor my dad knows your dad. And this is how we've been. Two different families worried about our own selves. And there was nothing that was overlapping for us to consider each other important. But now suddenly, whatever had caused it, the sense of love, the concept of love that has caused it is extremely strong, that I have fallen for you so much. And we are now with one another. We are emotionally bound. We are at a relationship level, we are bound so strong that we are inseparable. So much so inseparable, like water that has mixed with red alluvial soil. Like rainwater that falls and merges with the red earth, our loving hearts have become one. And please note here that rainwater is brought in here because it's very sudden. Generally, red earth is seen in hot arid region where rain is very scarce. When it happens, it kind of makes the complete area messy. The water mixes so much with the earth and it becomes kind of inseparable. And one fine day, it dries up so much that the water and soil are mixed together for eternity. That's how our love is. So it's that strong that it has brought in people who didn't know each other till the moment we met, so close now that mutually we are important to one another. Every other relationship that I've had, starting from my parents, my friends, my neighbors, nothing is as important to me from now on as you are. So that is this emotion that's also mutual is something that is very special when it comes to a relationship that's right between a couple. So, love and the life after that is considered like this. And this conversation is also set in Kurunji Thinai, which is the Thinai that is associated with making love and the kind of privacy and all that. So this conversation probably is immediately after making love and the sense of warmth is there that's very strong. And the hero addresses the heroine like this. This is how relationships were looked upon, especially a husband and wife relationship was compared to something very unique. I'm not sure if there is another poem in any other language which compares the kind of emotional, the kind of relationship that binds couples with red soil and water, rainwater that has just fallen on it. So that's something, it's a very special phrase and which is so special that the original name of the poet has been forgotten and he is also called by that very phrase. Now that's a very popular song, but I thought I should share it with people who would have probably heard this song. Next episode, I'll again meet you with another song from the Agam genre. Till then, thank you.